Well, hey friends, and welcome back to the second half of our last Disneyland day on our couples trip. That's a mouthful, but let's go ahead and get it back into the parks for the second half of our day and get into some fun together.
Been where? Which way?
It's been
four. Oh! Holy smokes, Roger! We've been there!
It'll be cost five! It's quite worth it. Yeah, it's intense.
Wow. Benny, Lanny, Lanny, Lanny. That golden hour, the glow. All right, friends, I had a nap. We came back. Security was long, the lines were long, we had to walk, it was a mess. But we're here for our final evening.
We headed straight into Downtown Disney in order to hit the Lego store to do some shopping for the kiddos. And then after that, we actually did a few more rides in Disneyland. We had another virtual queue for Haunted Mansion, so we did that. And then we kind of walked around. It was very crowded this day. In particular, this was a Friday, and the weekends are always so crowded, so much more crowded than the weekdays. So that's something we always notice. So it takes a lot longer to get places and to like do different things that you want to do, which was definitely the case this night. But it was fine. We did end up going to Golden Horseshoe to have some food.
Tendies. This is kind of cool. They put like tag on it though. I kind of like that.
In honor of our kids.
Huh?
In honor of our kids.
Like my husband said, this meal was definitely like in honor of our kids kind of a situation. We had chicken tenders and french fries, and then we both got Roy Rogers to drink, so just cherry cokes. This place is really great. There's lots of indoor seating in here. It does get a little bit loud, but as you can see, if you have picky kids, they have totally great kids food here, and I really like that. They also have great ice cream creations here. So they have a float flight. It's like three different ice cream floats right now for magic key holders that you could try. They also have different seasonal ice cream things and stuff like that. So tons of great options here at Golden Horseshoe. It's like a little hidden gem, I think. After we had our meal, we headed over to get a spot to watch Fantasmic. We definitely did not pick a good spot for this show, but it was our first time seeing it, our first time experiencing it, and trying to figure out where to sit. I think what we would do next time is go around towards the Haunted Mansion and sit on that side, or stand on that side, because I overheard a cast member say that that's kind of a clear view, and they sort of squish everyone in once the show begins, so you get more space over in that area. So I think if you are heading to see Fantasmic and looking for a spot, you don't have like a dining package, you just are going to stand and watch the show, I would head towards that way over near Haunted Mansion, kind of closer to that way of the Rivers of America. So anyway, great show. We loved it so much, and we cannot wait to bring our kids back so they can see it too.
Spirited and all Hallows Eve celebration.
So immediately following Fantasmic, we rushed over to get a spot right in front of It's a Small World, which you can see off to the right hand side on the bottom. And we wanted to stand here to see the fireworks and the projections, because I had heard that the projections are the best to watch on It's a Small World, and I would definitely agree. You can see them a lot better, a lot more visual than if you're standing on Main Street. On Main Street, it's really hard to see the projections because of the buildings. So it's perfect on It's a Small World because it's like a big white facade that you can watch everything from.
And now I've saved the best for last, the Halloween Scream Along. You're all invited to scream like you're trying to wake the dead.
Great.
Come on, Zero. We'll take flights to you. Oh, okay.
Well, as always, friends, thank you so much for watching. My husband and I had such an incredible anniversary trip, and it's so fun, as always, to bring you guys along and share the magic with you. I hope you've enjoyed watching this vlog series of our anniversary trip, and I hope that if you haven't yet, you will subscribe so that you can join us for our next adventure. It's much sooner than you think. The next vlog you'll see is actually our travel day home, and we'll do a whole recap of our thoughts on the anniversary trip, Oogie Boogie Bash, and all the good Halloween stuff. So I will see you there, friends. Bye!